Coach Maggie, certified health and lifestyle coach. Happy New Year's. Today I want to talk about three things that are really simple that you could literally start today that could really boost your health and make you feel better. They're not going to be things that you're just going to be like, oh my goodness, tomorrow morning. You know, so often we're looking for that big thing because we see so much advertised on TV. If you just take this pill, if you just eat this box of food that's delivered to your door, if you just do this thing, it's going to make a world of a difference and you're going to lose 20 pounds. You're going to think clearer. You're going to sleep better. But do you realize it's a lot of little things that really makes the difference? And we want to take those little things and make them habits, build them into routines that are there for life. Do you want to eat out of a box for the rest of your life? No, no one does. And most of these things are offering something quick, but it doesn't really change us. And so I want to talk about some things that are free that you can do, you can start right away, and will make a difference. But again, they're not going to be overnight, but we have to consistently do them. The first one is eat intentionally. You know, we tend to be on the go constantly. 20% of meals are eaten in the car. So that means you're eating fast. Maybe you've pulled over. Maybe you're just pulling out of the drive-thru and you're eating on the go. You're eating a breakfast sandwich on the way to work, or you run on your lunch hour to get something quick, or it's dinner, whatever it is. That's a lot of meals eaten in the car. And let's face it, we're not in a very necessarily a relaxed atmosphere. So we tend to eat quick. We're often spilling things, making a mess, and we're in a hurry. So let's be intentional. Let's be mindful of what we're eating. Eat at home, at a table, sitting down. People often eat standing. And I have to agree or admit, I was one of those people. Often I was multitasking. That leads to tons of digestive problems. Okay? So we need to make sure that we are intentional. You know, as kids, probably most of us grew up saying our prayers, and we live in such a busy time that even I'm reading medical things that talk about the benefit of gratitude and pausing before we eat to acknowledge this food came from a farmer somewhere or the hands that prepared it. But this is a practice we all need to go back to, is praying before a meal, giving ourselves time to breathe and then be ready to enjoy. Another thing that we don't think about, but chewing slowly, this is a biggie. And again, I am guilty. When I was going through my training to be a health coach, this was one of the things that I learned. And I was shocked. I thought, what difference does that make? But it really makes a huge difference. We're putting a lot more strain on our body when we're only taking 5-10 bites and boom, it goes. Because it's got to be broken down so that it can go through the digestive tract. And the more we chew so that things are liquid, the easier it is on our digestion. The less of those, you know, horrible problems that you hear advertised on TV, whether it's gas, bloating, constipation, diarrhea. I mean, they've got the jingles around that. But that's one of the most common things for Americans in particular, because we always are eating fast. And again, it goes back to eating in the car. Chances are you're eating fast too. When I worked in the school, I used to eat at my desk every single day. But I tried to have music on or something. But still, we need to make sure where we're eating is conducive to enjoying our food. The last one may be a hard one, but we need to do it, is we need to get rid of the distractions. This is a biggie. Most people are eating either in front of the TV or in front of a device, their phone, an iPad, the computer. Again, totally messes up with the digestion. Because again, we may not think about it, but as you're watching the morning news and they're showing highlights of a war in another country, even though you may not feel like you're stressed about it, your brain is thinking, oh my goodness, look at that, or they're showing scenes of a bad accident, or you're watching a movie at night and it's a chase scene. Even though you're sitting there, what you think calmly, your brain is reeling. Are they going to make the corner? Is someone going to get killed? Is someone going to get shot? And so when the brain goes into that mode, everything else shuts down. Because it's hard for the brain to distinguish that you're not in danger. Person on the TV is, not you. But the brain sees danger and it tells every part of your body, danger. So then when it does that, everything else slows down. So we need to work on those things. We need to be more intentional. A good way to do that is start by saying grace before your meal, acknowledging you've got food in front of you, sitting down. The next thing, chew, and chew some more. 25 to 30 chews per bite. Take smaller bites as well. Gives your brain time to realize, hey, I'm full, so I don't need to keep eating. So that's a way to cut down on how much you eat, which ultimately is going to cut down on what you weigh. And then the next thing is let's put away the phone, the TV, all of those things, and just sit and enjoy some calm time. All of these things, again, not one, together you will see a tremendous impact. It will not be tomorrow. You probably won't notice anything. But you will, over time, find yourself eating less so you feel lighter. You're digesting your food so you're feeling lighter. When we chew and we swallow these big chunks, again, it makes the stomach, it makes everything work harder. But guess what? When there's more down there that needs to be processed, then pretty soon you've got lunch on top of breakfast and then dinner. And then it's like your body never catches up getting rid of what you ate 2, 3, 4 days ago. So all of these things are simple, but over time have huge, huge dividends. So I just want to encourage you. Do you struggle with any of these? I have with all of them. So definitely begin to work on those. Being intentional, chewing your food thoroughly, and staying in that calm state without all of the distractions. So I'd love to hear your thoughts. Which one do you struggle with the most? Let me know, and let's talk about ways to break those bad habits. So, anyway, I'd love it if you'd leave a comment, like this page, follow me, and enjoy your day and enjoy your meals. Make sure it's good food and enjoy it.